there's plenty to go around, as you may see. Oh yeah, and I'm naming my little sprocket the Alp sprocket. Alpen sprocket. Yeah, Alpen sprocket. Let's go.
Thank you.
That's one mighty river. Yeah. Kandersteg-Hohtenn. All right. Too slow. Like good old times, it feels like good old times. It all feels like good old times at the moment. Probably the underfills kicked in. That's what I think. Anyway, 2 hours to go, and I'm feeling great. we talking about? Something flat. The road to Sion is flat. I like it. Maybe 2 weeks in Zurich, circle the Zurich lake, and then try myself by circling the Zurich lake, maybe cycling around a little bit, and then, oh yeah, and equipping my bike with rack, sort of backpacking. Glamping, what would you call a glam bikepacking? Because that's what I was trying to do.
200 meters, turn back.
Okay. Anyway, so and then I wanted to move up north to the northern Europe, from the central Europe, like Switzerland.
Continue straight.
Thank you. So and then nothing went as planned. I actually have trouble planning still. So I haven't built my rack just yet. I'm going to place order the day after tomorrow, Monday, and hopefully I'll build rack and start moving up north somewhere from Geneva. The week after that or something. But I circled the Zurich lake, it went fine, actually with more than plants. There's my suitcase got delayed and some other stuff happened. But finally I got out of street and to Basel. I went to Bern. 2 days of around 100 kilometers ride, one to Basel. And one to Bern through Biel. I got a bit fucked with the wreck because the person. The person who promised to build that track and didn't do it, so I went to go for nothing. And honestly, I don't see why anyone would want to go to Biel other than it's beautiful fucking everywhere here in Switzerland, so you might just go anywhere. But then go to Hohtenn or something. So Basel, Bern through Biel, or Bien. And now for some reason I'm going to Lausanne. The weather got me delayed a bit again. It's raining and the rain's actually quite nice. Some rains, but
continue straight.
I couldn't brave even that, so I got delayed and I'm going to Sion. Right now, from Bern, and from there tomorrow, if my ass feels okay, I will go to Lausanne, not sure how to pronounce it, but we'll find out. If we get there, when we get there, if we get there. Right now, wherever you're watching this, whenever, put some nice music to it. You can mute the audio. I won't be telling anything interesting. Not while riding my bike and my JBL charge dead, so I'm riding without music. And GoPro battery died once. I mean, the first battery died, now it's the second one. It will probably die in 40 minutes or something. But hopefully it shoots something that you should enjoy the sounds of your favorite music. There's really no reason to listen to me. My terrible accent and my breath. Bit of endorphins and the view is as better. So today went almost as planned despite Google Maps trying to ruin it for me. Or not, not sure. But I did my routing manually. It gave me yet another idea of a service for serious people. For, you know, freaky big people, nerdy travelers who want to plan their routes and use the navigation properly. Anyway, so almost died. Actually got off the bicycle, got off my bicycle when getting up to Kandersteg, not sure. So it's really high up in the Alps. I think 1200 or 1300 meters up in the Alps. But got there in time, relatively speaking. Oh shit. This looks like one of these games. Great. Now I get some water on the lens. It will really help the footage. With all the rainbows and shit. So, which brings us to our next subject. Some people have some problems with some gay people. I'm not saying I'm one of those people, and I'm not saying I had any problems with any of those. But I'll just tell you what happened.
Turn right.
Right at the endorphins. I mean, what might have happened to someone. So, as you might have guessed, I do a lot of Airbnb at the moment. It was probably my 6th or 7th overnight Airbnb this trip. So, obviously, sometimes I stay at gay people's. Which is fine. I mean, normally it's even better than fine because they're extra friendly and extra knowledgeable of all the fun things around and extra experienced with hosting people and all the nice things. Sometimes you get a room with not much in it, not even a chair to hang your clothes, but with a really, really posh bed. I mean, king size wouldn't do it justice if I tell you it's just king size bed. It's a king's bed. And with that bed come silk bed sheets in black.
So the area room, which has a bed and a dresser in it, and it's a really, really nice bed. I mean, come on. One other thing that you have, that a lot of aromatic stuff in the room. I mean, to the point where fragrances section in your drugstore is a fresh air compared to it. And I know fresh air because I've been just cycling through Alps, which I still do, if you haven't noticed. So you can hardly breathe in the room. So you remove some of the aromatizers from the room and you think of like sleeping alone on those sealed black bed sheets. Look at the view. And finally, it's kind of fine. It's not the best. I actually like rougher bed sheets. But to get through the sticky feeling and the color doesn't really matter in the night when you sleep, okay, with the lights off and stuff. But somehow I got that feeling. Those sheets are trouble. And there it was. Today's morning, I usually, as usual, postpone all the most important stuff to the less comfortable part of the day for me, the morning. And I packed my suitcases, which I sent through Swiss mail later today. And before that, I like to lay it all out on the bed, you know, just to see what I have, to see what I have to take with me and want to send ahead to my next destination, which is Lausanne, okay? So I got it all laid out. And I packed my suitcases and I went out to send them via via post, and via post worked perfectly well. I sent them. I will hopefully receive them with Posto Restante in Lausanne. Then I get back home and I pack my backpack and my bike bag and getting ready to roll out, right? And then you discover that your perfectly black bag holding your paper stuff sits there on this black bed sheet on the bed unnoticed. And that's how you add 2 to 3 kilograms to your backpack, just like that. So I'm not saying it couldn't happen in a straight view, in a straight couple's house or something, but it didn't. Well, that's why I personally don't have any problem with gay people, but some people might do. I will be stopping soon for my stretches, because I think it would be exactly the right moment to do that. Look at the cat with the dandelion.
Cat fight.
Not here. Oh, look at something. That must be a couple of workers. So nice. Dandelion sculptures and orcas.
In 200 meters, at the roundabout, take the third exit.
Third exit. You see Lausanne and Sion. So my first destination today is Lausanne. I wonder if I get there before total darkness. Let's see. Enter the roundabout. Okay, so it's 1 hour 20 minutes. I say push some more distance, like 20 minutes, and then make my stretches. I'm on iPhone. yeah, pretty much useless. I think that they could just have left the sign and this man called the police. Oh, nice house. Drinking water. Here it just, the mountain is great, isn't it? like closing out the fields on those streets. There's a field remains that we'll need to go up again. Anyway, here's the sunset setting for you. Sunset setting. In the Alps. Kandersteg, and oh look, one cow licking another cow. How cute. So Kandersteg to Hohtenn, and then it was the descent that we've seen in the beginning. What should I take where?